boolean expression using camel. As we have already discussed that how to simplify a boolean expression using the basic postulates or theorems. But when the variables are 3 or 4 and it is very difficult to simplify a boolean expression using the algebraic method. So here the K-map or Karnaugh map you can use to simplify any boolean expression. So in this video I am going to tell you how to solve the boolean expression. Okay, so here I made three tables, one for two variables, second for three variables, and third for four variables. So if you have two variables, three variables, or four variables, you have to make these tables. Okay, so it is necessary that if you are going to solve any boolean expression, it must be either in canonical SOP form or canonical POS form. If the expression is not in canonical SOP or POS, then first we have to make it in canonical SOP form or in POS form. If you don't know what is canonical SOP POS, so I will give you the link in the description. You can go to that video also. When we use KMAP, first we have to fill the KMAP. Now, first we will understand very carefully how to fill this KMAP. Okay. 0, 1, 2, then 3. It is y bar, y, x bar, x. So here the entry will come x bar, x bar, y, x, y bar, x and y. Okay, now let us move to the third variable. 0, 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7. Here you have to keep in mind 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, now what will be the entries? X bar, X, Y bar, Z bar, Y bar, Z, Y, Z, Y, Z, bar. So these are the entries of three variables. Now for the four variables, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So here you have to memorize this numbering 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7. And this is row 8, 9, 10, 11, then third row you have to fill 12, 13, 14 and 15. The corresponding entries will be Y bar, Z bar, Y bar, Z, Y, Z, Y, Z bar. Same as W bar, X bar, W bar, X, W, X, W, X bar. Now, why we need to write this numbering and these X bar, y bar, z bar. Please listen it carefully. See. In canonical SOP form or POS form, we can write the Boolean terms in cardinal form. We can write the Boolean terms in cardinal form. So these are the cardinal values. So this KMap, these KMap can be filled using these cardinal values or using the XYZ, whatever be the given in the question. So for this cell, the entry will be X bar, Y bar, Z bar. For this X bar, Y bar, Z, like this, you can fill all the entries X bar, Y, Z, X, Y, Z bar. X, Y bar, Z bar, X, Y bar, Z, X, Y, Z, X, Y, Z bar. Same as you can fill all this KMap. Let us solving the question. Okay. Now the most important thing is how we will solve the questions. See, we have given in question, we have given a set of terms. These Boolean terms will be there. Three variables, then three variables come, four variables come, will be there. So, whichever be the term is given in the questions, first we have to make this KMap. After making KMap, the terms which are given in the question, for those in those cells, we will write one. For example, if the terms are given W, X, Y, Z bar plus W bar, X, Y bar, Z, like this, if the terms are given. So what you will do? When you solve the question, you will not write these terms here. You can write only 0, 1, 2, 3, but these terms you will not write. So instead of this, what will you do? Now the question is given W, X, Y, Z bar. So first, you will find where W, X, Y, Z bar will come. So W, X, Y, Z bar, Y, Z bar is there. So intersection is this cell. Okay, so this is the intersection, means this is the cell where we have to mark W, X, Y, Z bar. So what we will do? We will write here. And we solve the question. We will write here one. Same as for the next one. W bar, X, Y bar, Z. So first we will find where, which cell this term is representing. W bar, X, Y bar, Z. So this is the cell where this term is representing. Okay. So like this, whatever the terms are given, for those terms, others, for those terms we will write one in each and every cell, and the remaining cell which is unoccupied means where we have not write nothing, there we will write zero. Okay students? Okay, so this is how you will fill the KMap. After filling KMap, first we have to understand the rule of octet. Octet means group of 8. So when we solve this KMap, first we will check whether any octet is present in what is octet? See, octet is group of 8. If 8 adjacent cells having 1, so that will make a group, or we can say that that is a octet. For example, this and this. If in all these cells one is there, so it means they are making a octet. Okay. This and 1, 2, 3, 4. Now also, suppose there is also one. So again, these are making octet. Okay. Now this. 4, 5, 7, and 6. 8, 9, 11, and 12. Now we can see these are not making a group of 8 cells. They are not adjacent. So they are not making any octet. Okay, this is how you will find octet. One more thing for octet. This row, this column, and this column are adjacent. It means this means this complete column and this complete column will make a octet. Okay, from this edge and from this edge, they are not together, but when we solve the question, we will consider them together. This column and this column, this row and this row also. Okay, it means if 1, 1, 1, 1 means all ones are here and this ones are also here. So it means this row and this row will make a octet. So this is the concept of octet. After finding all the octets, we will find quads. Quad means group of 4 cells. Like this are making a quad. This making a quad. Okay. Don't take it quad. It is quad. Q-U-A-D. This and this. These are also making a quad. Okay, this. 2 cells and these 2 cells. Since we consider these are as a adjacent rows. Okay, so this is also making a quad. Now this and this. This is also a quad. Okay, students, so this is how you will find quad. After finding quad, pair means group of 2. These 2 are pair. This and this, these are pair. This and this, this is also a pair. Okay, students, so this is how you will find a pair. Okay, now the next thing is, after finding all these quads, pairs, octets, how you will solve? Okay. So for this, let us take an example. We will clear this with the help of an example. Okay. So here I have written a question. F x y z is sigma. Sigma means S O P, and in cardinal form, we have given a expression. Okay. So what we will do first? First we will make a KMF. We'll make like this one. So whatever the numbers are given, so on in these cells we have to write 1. So 0, 1, 2, 0. 7, 6, 7, right one. 8, 9, 10, 11. 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So we have done all the entries. Rest others we will fill 0 in the others. So after filling this Carnot map, first thing that we have to do, we have to find octet, then quad, then pair. So what the octet you can see here? See these four elements and these four elements are making a octet. Okay. So in the solution you will write. One, what are the 0, 1, 2, 3, 8, 9, 10, 11. 0, 1, 2, 3, 8, 9, 10, 11. So this is the octet one. So in octet, what you will do? So in octet, you will see the variable which is not changing. Now see, W bar, X bar. W X bar. So in all the 8 cells, X bar is the variable which is not changing. So for this octet, solution is X bar. Okay. Now we will find the quads. This is the quad. Now the same thing we have to check here. For this solution, we have to see, we have to check the variable which is not changing. So y z bar. So y is not changing for all these four. Y is not changing. We will write quad. Quad 1, the quad 2, 3, 6, 7, 2, 3, 6, 7. Y is not changing, so one of the solution is Y. What is the value of W and X here? W bar, X bar, W bar, X. So W bar is also not changing for these four cells. So the solution for this quad is W bar. Now, is there any other quad? No, there is no any other quad. Now, we will go for the pair. So, there is only one pair. Okay, there is only one pair. We will write in solution pair 1. The sets are 8 and 12. 8, 12. Okay. Which is not changing? That we have to write. W bar, Z bar, not changing. Okay, so W bar, Z bar, and for this WX, for this WX bar, which is not changing, obviously W is not changing. So here we will write W. So for pair 1, the solution is this. So finally, we will come to our solution, that is. X bar plus WY plus WY bar Z. So this is the solution of the question. Okay, students. So one more thing that you have to keep in mind, whenever we make any octet, it will remove three variables. Means only one variable will be there. For quad, quad will remove two variables, means when you solve a quad, two variables will be there. And for pair, pair will reduce one variable. It means in solution, you will get three variables. students, now if you have any other doubt, please write in the comment.